Hello everyone, Marine here for Lanfun, thanks for stopping by. Today I'm going to make a pull-tab card showcasing the brand new Dandy Day stem set. This set is super cute with those sweet little mice and beautiful dandelions. I'm also going to use some additional stems to help me complete my scene, so make sure to check the description box below the video if you need more details. So first, I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches stitch rectangle out of Bristol cardstock. And I'm going to use tumble glass distress ink and the new cloudy stencil to create a beautiful sky. My clouds are done, so now I'm going to add a little bit of texture. I pressed my tumble glass ink pad onto my glass mat. I added water, and now I'm just splattering drops on my panel. I always do this on my cards because I think it brings more interest and makes the panel less flat. To ground my scene, I cut a grass border using a die from the Simple Grassy Hillside die set. And I'm using Shabby Shutters and Peel Paint Distress Inks to color it. First, Shabby Shutters all over the border, and next, Peel Paint at the top to add shadows. And I will also add splatters of the same inks on that border. I stamped and cut my images off screen. On the left, I have images from the new Dandy Day stamp set. And on the right, I have trees from the Tree Before and After's stem set and flowers from the Elfie Selfie stem set. The butterflies are from the Butterfly Kisses stem set, but I'm not going to use them. So everything was stamped using jet black ink and cut using the coordinating dies, and I'm using my alcohol markers to color everything. The coloring is done, so now I can stamp my sentiment. I think you're dandy and I'm not lying. And I stamp it twice to get a nice impression. Now to the pull tab mechanism. I start by tracing a vertical pencil line right in the center of my panel. I place the mouse and mark on the line where I want it to stop. And next, I tape the slit die on the line right below the pencil mark. I also tape the notch die at the top of my panel and I send it to my die cutting machine. I need the mouse to go very low so it can hide behind the grass border, so I simply continue to die cut the slit towards the bottom of my panel. I die cut the pull tab off screen, applied double-sided tape on the tabs and folded the score lines. I put this element through the slit at the back of the panel. And I die cut the sleeve that I'm going to stick at the back of the panel to secure the tab, keep it in place, and make sure it goes up and down straight. Now, obviously, the mouse is too small and the tabs could be noticeable. So I'm just trimming those pieces as thin as possible, so they become invisible behind the mouse. So the size of the tabs looks good to me. Now I'm sticking the mouse. And before moving on to the next step, I'm attaching the remaining piece of sky at the very top of the pull tab, so the design stays consistent. Next, I applied two layers of foam tape at the bottom of the panel, making sure not to touch the mouse. I removed the backing paper and attached the border to finally hide the little mouse. I applied two layers of foam tape again, but this time at the back of my panel that I stuck to a white card base. Now I can finally adhere all my cute images using a combination of foam squares, glue dots and liquid glue. I wanted those dandelions to be looking in the opposite direction, the big one to the right and the small one to the left. So I just cut their heads off and glued them back at the other end of the stem. Now you can see that the mouse is going a little bit too high. So to stop it lower, I just attach dandelion sprigs right above the slit and using a tiny piece of foam squares. And now the mouse is stopped and cannot go higher. The card is almost done, but I still need to attach an arrow at the top of the pull tab. I used the arrow die from the Les Toast pull tab die set, and it was cut out of sunflower cardstock to coordinate with the yellow dandelions. And finally, I did what I do on most of my cards, because I think it adds extra cuteness to a scene. I added white nouveau drops in the center of each dandelion and flower. And that's it, all done and so stinking cute with this sweet little mouse grabbing onto a dandelion and flying away. I hope you like this card and tell me in the comments what do you think about this new Dandy Day stamp set. Have a very nice day and see you very soon. Bye!